I've had headaches for 2 solid years. They're gone.
I went from not walking, literally could not take a step, to then in 4 to 6 weeks being able to not have pain anymore. Believe what you want, but that's my story.
There you go, keep breathing, that's it. There you go.
My wife has to deal with it. I'm a tough guy, I think I can take it. And now to see her see me out of pain, and the look she has in her eyes, she got kind of misty-eyed the other day.
We were in the weight room working out again, getting ready for the season, and I was squatting. As I went down on probably like the second or third rep, out of nowhere I just felt a snap in my back, and I had no idea what happened, and I immediately dropped to the floor, couldn't get up, couldn't really feel my legs even. I was thinking, could I ever walk again, honestly? I had no idea.
That's really what this entire documentary is about. Texas citizens' freedom of choice to choose to come see a chiropractor first if they wish to. If a patient comes to see me for their neck pain and their back pain and their headaches and their sciatica and all those things, they're not going to the medical doctor. So who's losing the office visits and the surgeries and the procedures and the revenues? It really all boils down to money when you get down to it.
We exist, now remember this, with one of the most powerful, rich lobbying groups, the American Medical Association. We still exist with them trying to eliminate this profession after all these years.
At one point, the Texas Medical Board joined with the Texas Medical Association to sue the chiropractic board. The Texas Medical Association's gone after the podiatrists, they've gone after the marriage and family therapists, and so these are all non-MD provider groups the TMA wants to hold down. Year after year, session after session, our goal going forward is not expansion of scope. That's a misnomer. Clarification of scope. We don't want to be Stone Age chiropractic, and honestly, if you're a patient, you don't want that either.